Things in my psych ward room that just make sense. Blind so the nurses can do rounds. A thermometer that doesn't work. Here's an overview of my room. How nice, how pretty. Not one closet, but two. Only one of them is locked. My beautiful desk. Now this is the cool part. Look at these blinds. They're automatic. Isn't that so fucking cool? Like, I'm literally obsessed. I've never had a psych ward like this before. This is my view. So pretty, so nice, I guess. My bathroom, how nice and blue. My shower is the favorite part. It's a rainfall shower. How nice. That's me.
Look! Nigga don't like me, kill me right now. Otherwise, nigga, pipe down. Y'all niggas rap too loud, nigga. What's that sound? That's me sneaking in your house with a trap. I'ma put that bitch in your mouth.
Good morning. Ooh, morning, Mr.
Just got out of the mental asylum fit check. Ooh. Ooh, you already know I stole, like, five of these socks. Bitch, the grip? Sis.
Yo, this one goes out to all my mentally unstable chaps and chapettes with a fat CCG trust fund. My name's Charlotte. I live in this ward. Where you find the girls, we are really bored. Everyone's sectioned. Everyone's crossed. I reckon you'll find, with your little please not. Everyone has BPD. Mental stability, who is she? Everyone asks, Charlotte, what kind of hospital are you in? And I just say, you're in a psych ward. The doors are locked 24/7, lights out at 11. You're in a psych ward. We live off the government's money. We're ever so sorry, but we're on a section 3, section 3, it's not up to me.
I just caught the most disgusting thing in my room.
Okay, like, I'm kind of scared to look at it again because it was so gross. Like, I don't know how this shit got into my house, but... Okay. Ew!
Stories from the psych ward.
Some of you have been asking for a happy one, so don't say I never did anything for you. I hate children, but one time I was on the kids unit and there was a little boy there who was there for depression, and I taught him how to solve a Rubik's Cube, and he got released when I wasn't there, so he left me a note in crayon that said, I got out, Miss Darla, thank you for making me laugh, and I love your old person name, and I keep that note on my fridge. One time I had a patient who'd been an alcoholic his whole life, so he was basically paralyzed when he came to us, and he was with us for 2 months, and then at the end of the 2 months he was able to walk out by himself, and it was so sweet. One time I had a patient who came to us after a suicide attempt, and the other day he actually messaged me and told me how well he's been doing, and he has a girlfriend now, and he wrote a song inspired by me, and it was sweet, and I cried. The nicest patient I ever had was an old man with like 6 chronic illnesses, including cancer, and I said, hey, it's really inspiring, but how can you be so caring and positive after all your suffering? And he said, well, if it's inspiring, then my suffering is worth it.
Things people don't tell you before going into the psych ward, part 1.
It's literally not like the movies, it is super chill. You basically sit around and watch movies all day, so that's kinda great. Depending on where you are, the food's so freaking good!
Like for part 2.
Hit the strip out of school, couldn't wait till I got out of class. Used to stare at the clock and shit. Before all this rap shit, I was gang banging and doing half beats on the cops and shit. And I'm straight from the shop, but I ball like a king up at Cali and shoot like Stojakovic. Keep applying that pressure, I go on the run, it ain't no letting up.
December 31st, I grabbed a beer, threw it up, said 2020 is my year, bitches. And I honestly thought that that was true until I gave this motherfucker like a month or two. This is getting kind of ridiculous at this point.
Yeah, when you shower, you have to press that button every 30 seconds to keep the water running.
Steph isn't looking. Write your snap on this really quick.
Okay, but hospital socks hit different. No, look, I'm pretty sure everybody in here listens to Girl in Red. Hey, Macy, can I get a Band-Aid? If you even try to tell me Danny Phantom isn't hot, I will kill you.
Ah!
Ooh, do you think she's gonna get the booty juice?
Ashlyn, are you awake? We need to draw your blood.
I am now.
Name some unhealthy cooking
skills. Oh, I got this one. Sex, drugs, alcohol, self-harm.
Your mom's calling.
I really don't want to talk to her right now. Just tell her I, like, died or something. I don't know. Can I please take snack to group? If you say no, I'll kill myself.
Yeah, I'll really miss you, but I hope I never see you again.
I'm back!
Yeah, no, they take everybody's shoelaces.
Anti-suffocation bed sheets, fucking mint. Anti-leak curtains, fucking mint. Windows that physically cannot open, fucking mint. TVs locked in by screws, fucking mint. Gap in the bathroom door so they can watch you shower, fucking mint. Everything sloped so you don't hang yourself, fucking mint. Plastic mirror, fucking mint. Emergency call buttons, fucking mint. Tiny charging cords, fucking mint. At night, the nurses come in and shine a torch on your face every hour, fucking mint. Locks that open from either side, fucking mint.
Please send me
things in the psych ward that just do make sense. We have nurse calls on our walls in case of an emergency. Our windows are double glazed and they only open a little bit so that we can't escape. Our mattresses are like blue PE mats you get at school, so you can't break them. We have safety plugs so that we can't stick forks in them. Our batteries are glued in so that we can't access them. And we also have safety sinks so we can't, yeah. And also we have plastic mirrors that make us look funny.
In a psych war, this time I can't escape, they assured me. I see a man who headbutts a wall constantly. His head is wrapped in gauze, but still bloody. He's that nutty, and check that girl out over there. She's beautiful, too bad she pulled out all her hair. All I care about is finding my way out of here. They got a guy in here who throws his own shit.
My mental hospital journal, that just makes sense. I was teaching a girl how to write G's because she didn't know how. This was my picture. This was 2 days after I got admitted. Whatever this is. Me yelling. I was trying to remember all the states from memory. I was literally 17. I don't know why I wouldn't have known all of them. Yeah. Me bullying my therapist. It says, also I hate my therapist because one of her eyes is smaller than the other one and it makes me mad. I had no reason to say this about her. Writing very meaningful things for journal time.